I have to do this video. Hey guys, Fenya, that is FY Dublin, and yeah, out of the FA Cup, 2-1-0. That's quite embarrassing. I have to say, it's really just, it was embarrassing and disgraceful to watch. Yeah, I'm not too sure what to say about that. I think definitely not one of our best performances. As I said, I'm now on holiday. I mentioned that last week. I can now I'm going to make more videos over the next 2 weeks. I'm going to try uploading as much as possible. I would have uploaded yesterday, sorry, but due to load shedding, I couldn't. And if you don't know what load shedding is, it's basically they cut off our power, and yeah, it's all for a few hours, so we never know if that's going to happen. Hello? Okay, so basically, not our best performance. I have to say, first half, defensive-wise, we really did struggle. But well done, Romero did so incredibly well, I have to say. He was just amazing. I think just some saves he made were just legendary and just true stuff for Manchester United goalkeeper. I think statistically, he is our best ever goalkeeper at Manchester United. I think, like, game to clean sheet ratio and saves beats, or I'm not sure, something like that beats Edwin van der Sar, Schmeichel and De Gea, so that's really good, that's really impressive, well done to him. But overall, our defence was shocking. I mean, Lindelof had such a horrible game. I mean, he's been improving game by game, and then he does this, and it's like, why are you in the team? I think his marking was horrible. I think he had a huge reason. He was a huge reason why we lost. I think our team as a total just like apart completely. Just not our best game. I mean, we did get one back at the end, but that goal means absolutely nothing. Sorry, Rashford. I think we really have to step up. And I want to talk about the fact that is Solskjaer really the right man for the United job? And I want to say this without sounding like every United fan, so let me push this out there. Manchester United fans all over social media are just, they're putting hate towards Solskjaer, saying, oh yeah, let's get rid of him, he's not doing what he wants. Yet 2 weeks ago they were in love with him. I still, as I said, I'm sure I said in a video before this, that it's very dangerous for us not to get the best of the best in terms of managers and players, and that he doesn't have experience with winning with a top club, Solskjaer. Is he the right man for the job? Possibly. As I said, it still needs to be a season. Even when he had his winning streak, I still thought it was too soon to appoint him as manager. Right now, I mean, he hasn't been doing that badly, but I mean, after that PSG game, losing to Arsenal and now losing to Wolves, it's a huge step back. I mean, Solskjaer himself said the passing was horrible. Pogba did an awful job, I have to say. I mean, sorry, Paul, but it wasn't the best birthday for you. And yeah, I mean, you're a captain and everything, but to be honest, I didn't see you the whole game. So yeah, I mean, that was pretty disappointing. Just as a team, I was very disappointed in the team. It was really not one of our best performances by any means. And we're really going to have to step it up. And the main talking point I want to get into is, everyone's talking about the different players we should sign once it is transfer window, but the main problem is I see everyone is talking about like a Gareth Bale or someone, which I'm tired of us getting players who aren't currently in the best form of their life. We need a player who's in the best form of their life, who's considered one of the best, at least within the top 20 of the Ballon d'Or, I would say. That might sound rough, but we are a big team. That is exactly what we should do and what is needed of us. It is what's required of us, no matter what you think. But yeah, we can't go out by players like that when we need to improve our defense. Our defense is our biggest problem. We can't just skip around our defense. We can't say, yeah, let's buy another tackle, another midfielder. Our problem is letting in goals. I think that's a huge problem. We need to get top players. I've said this for a long time. If Barcelona or Real Madrid or a top club wouldn't buy our defense, why do we have them? If we don't have players that another top club wants, why do we have them? Be honest, a huge club would never want Chris Smalling. I mean, I love Chris Smalling, but be honest, I mean, if a top club doesn't want them, why do we have them? I mean, that's the point of us being a big club. So the only thing we can do is really just try sit forward from here. because I've noticed since Solskjaer's first game to this game, it's progressively getting worse and it's out of the honeymoon phase now. Okay, that's a fact. I mean, we have just slightly gotten worse game by game, but now that we've done badly against the not one of the best teams, I mean, no offense to Wolves, but not one of the best teams, then yeah, then it's quite embarrassing and people notice it. But I think Solskjaer has to really reevaluate the team and see what he can do, see what he can do, if he can push it, if he can just get the best off the players, book up the players. Yeah, that was just a shocking game, and it's an embarrassment to be a United fan after that game. I mean, of course I'm proud of the club, but that was not a Manchester United team out there. Okay guys, so thanks for watching this video. I'm very close to hitting 50 subscribers. Can you guys please help me reach that goal as soon as possible? I'd love that so much. Like, subscribe yourself if you're not subscribed, and I'll be making more content as much as possible this holiday. So yeah, I'm not in the cages of school anymore. So yeah, hope you enjoy the videos. Thanks, this has been FinFYE. I knew it, I am just going to cool it.